What do you think the value of independent cinema is, both for storytellers and for audiences?
I think independent filmmaking or independent cinema gives creative people the opportunity to tell very unique stories, stories that can have a profound impact on audiences. And that's harder to do at the level which needs studio support or bigger financial support. At the independent level, that creativity can still exist. There's creativity throughout cinema making, but at the independent level, that's something that can be generally exciting, especially as a creative to be part of it. Going forward, I think platforms like Raindance are going to be vital, essential, like completely invaluable, in the sense that without them, I think a cinema, or independent cinema rather, might be at risk. It's important for communities to come together and develop art forms and communities to share what they think, how in what direction they think their art should go, and I think that's exactly what festivals like Raindance provide. So I'm going to be cheeky and just talk about a guy I work with called Mark Rizzo, who's got a film that's about to come out called Codacone. But he presented me with a script a few years ago that was so potentially dangerous, but actually the way he dealt with the story was very sensitive. So Mark Rizzo, Canadian director, I think is one to watch. Right now I'm working on a theatre project, and then I'm about to be part of a film. Not sure I'm allowed to talk about yet, but that is set in the early 20th century and is about a very important literary figure. It's great. I've absolutely kept up with Game of Thrones. It's the further away it gets in my memory, the sweeter the memory is, and also it means I'm more and more just a fan. Like I don't know anything that's going on right now, and there's a couple of years where I had to like shush my friends and go, oh, don't tell me when you're on set or not, because then I'll figure it out. But now I get to just like sit back with everybody else and just enjoy the ride. And this season has been electric. So. I haven't watched the latest, but the moment where Jaime Lannister goes for a swim, without being a spoiler, that moment kind of took my breath away. Just that whole proceeding. I don't want to spoil it just in case people haven't seen it. But the battle preceding that moment is great.
Fans are intensely debating who is going to end up winning on Game of Thrones, who's going to end up on that Iron Throne. Do you have a favourite or someone that you've got your fingers crossed for at the moment?
The deeper it gets, I mean, I always imagine like Brienne and Bran and the kids. I say the kids, I shouldn't say the kids, the young men and women, Arya and I've gone at Sansa. There we go, I went blank there. I imagine the Stark children as they were, but now young adults, sort of leading, with the help of Brienne, just to get a bit of Team Renly in there as well, but sort of leading it in a good direction. It's like a badge of honour being killed off by either or both George Martin and David and Dan. At the time, I sort of, it was just the end of what was a very exciting, scary time in my life. And now I just look back on it with quite a lot of fondness, really. It's an all right death. I think there are some more gruesome ones that would have been maybe a little bit cooler to be a part of. But I'm proud of Renly's exit. He's taking it from behind.